Hey YouTube, it's time for another Get Ready With Me video, and this is going to be a video very similar to the last one in the sense that it is a light, shimmery eye, a nude lip. It's what I've been doing a lot lately, you know, probably in my favorites video because I've just been drawn to it. And I'm going to use my Smashbox Heatwave palette because I don't think I've ever shown that in a Get Ready With Me. I think I had it in a favorites maybe like right after I bought it, maybe I didn't, I don't know. But it's a really, really amazing palette for crazily pigmented shimmery eyeshadows. Like, it's insane. These things crumble at the softest touch. They're just so beautiful. Makes it sometimes a little bit difficult to deal with because they're so soft, but I personally like the softer the eyeshadow the better. Just I'm like, ugh. Sorry if I sniffle or if I sound a little congested, feeling a little stuffy. Fighting it off. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to put on is this foundation primer from Laura Mercier, and I've been using this a lot lately just because I'm like, shit, I have it, why don't I use it? And I'll just pop this all over the face. By the way, just like in the last video, I already have some mascara, some Revlon Grow Luscious on my eyelashes because my schedule is, without, you know, giving too much away about my life, I typically come back and go to sleep after I work for an hour in the morning doing my nanny stuff. Now that I've got this nice primer all over my skin, I will take the Bobbi Brown Skin Foundation in 00 Alabaster. I think I mentioned this as like a half favorite in my previous video, really just because I was having super dry skin, but I've been kind of sloughing that off before I put on my makeup. And so the Skin Foundation SPF 15 Bobbi Brown 00 Alabaster has been my go-to. It just lasts so well on my skin, it looks so good. Right now I feel like it's like a tinge lighter than my skin tone, which is like crazy awesome. Like, oh my god, I have pigment for a little bit. I just really love how this has been looking on me lately, and I figured out, like, I think the best way that I like to apply it, because I was watching a Lisa Eldridge video, duh, and I'll put two pumps onto the back of my hand, but she said something about, like, basically wipe all of your foundation in and then just use a buffing brush to really buff it in, and that way the brush like isn't so wet. So what I've been doing is just that kind of thing where it's like, I'll just wipe it over my face so that it looks like really poorly blended in makeup. And I'll actually just wipe it in with my hands on my neck though, because I don't care about how that looks as much, but so it looks weird, right? Like totally gross. And then, so I still have some extra because I might need some little more, but that's when I'll take a clean buffing brush from Real Techniques, and that's when I will just buff what I already have actually into my skin, which I think has been looking really good. And then sometimes I might just like, oh, put a little extra right here. Doesn't it look nice? I mean, I don't really want to ask that question because someone's gonna be like, no. So just really soft buffing, rubbing motions all over the face. And then it also gets me to use less product, because I was using like three pumps or something when I was actually putting it on my thing, going like this and using that. So I'll just put whatever the excess is, because it just picks it up so quickly, and I'll just, you know, finish that up on my neck and pop a little on my ears. But I've been really satisfied with that technique as of late. Okay. So sometimes I'll just leave it straight like this, but if I just want a tiny bit more coverage, I will, well, first let's do a little concealing. So my chin could probably use a little bit of concealing, but because it's a day-to-day life and I'm not gonna be making a video after this, I don't really mind so much if I don't have the most concealed, flawless chin, even though I don't have any active breakouts going on, which I'm super stoked about. So gee bless the probiotics and drinking water and eating lots of broccoli and making sure that I use good products on my face and whatever the fuck helped. I am happy. That is what's going on. So, a little bit of this Clinique Airbrush Concealer in 01 Fair. My nails are so bad, look at that. Ugh. Painting your nails is an investment in time that I just don't have. So, why don't we just put a little bit there? I typically never use that around my nose, but hey, why not? So, got that bad boy on. I'm not gonna be putting any more concealer on. So now it's my last step for my more flawless face, but you know, a not heavily concealed face. And that's getting the MAC Studio Fix Powder in NW15 onto this MAC 107 brush and just swirl that in there and put it all over. So this is the first foundation pretty much that I ever bought. I just really was never felt confident with powder, liquid foundations when I was really young. So I owned this, one of the first things I ever bought makeup-wise for the face. And I consistently continue to just love it. A lot of times when my skin is great, it's like, you know, it's a Saturday, I wake up, I'm going to brunch or something, and I really just can't be bothered with slapping a face on. Just this powder all over, and I just love how it looks. So the face is all powdered, looking a little pale, looking a little flat. Let's add some dimension to it. So my other favorite thing that I've been doing a shit ton, which has been talked about in my favorites video, or will be, timelines, I never know, Kevin Aucoin Sculpting Powder Medium all over the cheeks. Use it as a blush. That's been my obsession lately. So Kevin Aucoin Sculpting Powder, just as a blush. I think it looks gorgeous. And by the way, I'm applying this with my e.l.f. complexion brush. That's what it's called. I love this combo together, these guys. And I like really swirl it in there. This thing's great because it picks up so little. So it looks a little scary on camera. Looks pretty good in real life. I've got that on. Now it's time to do the Kevin Aucoin Celestial Powder. And this stuff is also absolutely gorgeous. And so every year I try to get some of my cousins on my mom's side. I've got 3 girl cousins that are all within pretty close age to me. And so I try to buy them like one really good staple makeup product for Christmas every year. And the first year I did it, I've only been doing it for like 2 years now, but the first year I did it, I think I did the Naked palette. Then last year I did Dior Amber Diamond. And so I really want to do the Celestial powder, but I think that I already did a highlighter, so I mean, they're not huge makeup buffs like I am, so I'm thinking the contour powder should be what I do. So I think I might get them each a sculpting powder. Cell phone ringing. It's Soothing Sista, but I can't answer it right now because I'm making this video. Sorry, Stephanie. If you're watching this, Stephanie, I'm not ignoring your call. I just have to finish making this video before I'm late to work. I'll text you when it's over. Okay, getting this on. I'm actually gonna text her and be like, filming a video, sorry. It's nice to have a friend who does YouTube too, then you don't seem so crazy. Now I think I need to do my brows up with the Anastasia Brow Wiz in the color Brunette. And, oh, she left a voicemail. I'll listen to that in a little bit. Okay. Nice brushed out brows. Ooh, also preempt. I'm gonna put a little Urban Decay Primer Potion on my under eyes. Okay. I've been primed. So, now I'm going to do the... F it. I'm actually going to do my eyeshadow now. So, the reason I really wanted to make this video is because there's this eyeshadow. I'm looking for the brush. Here we go. This is what I like to apply it with. It's got the same color in it because I used it before. This is the EcoTools Blend Brush from its little kit. But, so I've been using this as my mirror, so I gotta take this off now. But this is the Smashbox Heatwave palette, and I'm talking about this color right here. It's frickin' crazy. That one right there in the corner is insanely beautiful. So that's what I'm gonna be working with. Okay, pop that all over the lid. It's very similar to Jess, so if you're somebody who owns this palette, you know, maybe you don't need to have both if you didn't already own Jest. I would say this one's like a little bit less pink. Maybe like more, it is kind of pink. I don't know. Kind of similar, but beautiful. So I'll just take that thing and apply it all over the lid. And then I'm gonna take the little brush that is included in this thing. See, a very nice fine little tip. And I just put that in there too and go underneath the eye. Underneath the eye. Okay, good stuff. So sometimes I'll take this one, I'll pop like a tiny bit into this. There's like kind of a mattish brown color in here, which is the top center. And warm up the crease just the slightest amount. You literally have to barely touch these shadows and you get so much product, it's insane. I love that. Okay. I need to see myself from far away so I can make sure I get like creasing kind of things correctly. So now I'm going to take from my kind of random palette, which I've now overfilled and kind of just like slam closed. I'm gonna take some of Vanilla from MAC and use that as the crease color, or not crease color, brow bone color. Blend it into the crease color. Works for me. Ooh, and I forgot what I kind of like to do sometimes is I just take Orange Blossom from Laura Mercier, this beautiful, beautiful blush. And sometimes I really have never been someone who's like an apple of the cheek person, but when I do this, it's all over, I'll just put the slightest amount right here. Okay, so I need a inner corner color. Let's go with Zephyr from Urban Decay, which is this little square that's on top of this other square. Stupid planning. But I need more palettes. I really want to get the new MAC palettes. I still have not gotten those yet. Wait. I feel like kind of bridally right now. I wonder if I'm at all inspired by the fact I just watched a bunch of Real Housewives of Miami and one of the chicks just got married. Anyways, Makeup Forever Smoky Lash. Time for the mascara. I'm putting it on top of the Revlon Grill Lashes because, as I said, it's a little bit of a cheat. It wasn't my completely bare naked face. I had a little bit of mascara on. But when I come home and I wash my face after I drive the kids to school, I'm a nanny, by the way. Somebody thought I had kids the last time I said that in my video. But no, I'm a nanny. But yeah, so I'll generally go home. What I do is, my super early morning routine is I wake up, I like moisturize my chin because it's a little dry. I slap some concealer on it, depending on if it's a really, what's the word? Oh yeah, fucked up. And then I will put some of the ginseng eye cream from Origins underneath my eyes because it really does brighten up. Like my eyes are like, I don't want to wake up right now. And then I put that stuff on. I look like I'm kind of okay with being here. That becomes the look my face gives. So I just do that. And then I come home. I wash it all off and then I go back to sleep and I wake up and then I put my makeup on and get my day started because I'm a lazy fuck. So mascara has been applied, I think it looks great, and I've got my Brow Wiz now from Anastasia, so I'm going to pop that into my brows. So here's one brow, looking good. I don't think they're looking very similar. Rats. What do I need to do? This needs to be like this. You know, they're not twins, they're sisters. Which is what I'm saying, because I just can't really, I'm not putting enough effort into making them look the same. It's kind of embarrassing because this is my Smashbox iBeam Double Ended Brightener. Which side does it come out of? Okay, oops. This is the side where it's completely broken off. This is the little bit of the pencil that's left, which I've been using to line my waterline. But I want to say a huge thank you to the person who told me that the Smashbox iBeam Double Ended Brighteners, this thing right here, are on beauty.com. I bought three of them. I had some drugstore dollars, so it wasn't too bad. But thank you so much. Because honestly, this is such a great color. It awakens my face so much. I have not been satisfied with some other ones I've tried. I know people recommended the Pixie Oyster Glow. I like that, but it's just not bright enough. So I think that's a beautiful metallic shimmery champagne color, kind of pinkish to go into the waterline, but it's just not, you know, the effect I'm looking for when I reach for this thing. Because this thing is more bright and creamy, a little bit of shimmer, but I don't want straight creamy, I don't want straight shimmer. I want this hybrid, which this gives me. So it's too bad it's been discontinued. So this is generally my probably super unsanitary way of lining my waterline. And I just love the effect that has. It's on this eye. I just think it makes my eye look really nice. So now I just insert that back into that dangerously spiky shell of a pencil, what it used to be, and I think I'm to the end of facial stuff, and it's just time now for the lips. And honestly, I was pretty lazy when getting this video together, and I was just like, I don't know where my that is, I don't know where my this is, so it's just going to be the Smashbox Lip Enhancing Gloss in a Loom. I'm sorry, guys. Just some lip gloss. I am feeling very bridal. I feel like I should be a bridesmaid. I think it's the side bun thing that I just threw on. I was planning on doing like a, and then this is how I curl my hair, but I ran out of time. I have to go to work. So, oh well. I don't know if I'll keep this hairstyle or if I'll put it into something else. All right, and then my last step always too can be sometimes just to make sure everything's nice and blend it together. So, this concludes my face for the day, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Maybe this would be a nice one to wear to a wedding or something. Anyone got in a wedding? But I feel like it's kind of like an icy winter cute doll bitch look. That'll be the title. It won't be. That's weird. I always am so confused. Like, how do I name a tutorial? Like, Winter Sally Girl. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope that you have a wonderful day. Bye.